We're here because our members elect us to be here and to represent them. So what do they want? What do working people want? I don't know if anybody's been paying attention for the last 18 to 20 months. Stuff's pretty screwed up outside right now, right? As a union president, my job over the last 18 to 20 months has been working with my members to protect them. There are basically no laws that protect workers in the public sphere in Pennsylvania. OSHA, if you're a private sector worker in OSHA, you know, raise your hand around here. Or if you're a private sector worker, raise your hand. If you live in a private sector, work in a private sector job, you have basic OSHA standards and protections. In the public sector, we don't even have those basic protections in Pennsylvania, right? So in this moment, I'm thinking of my brother Bilal, Bilal Talawi, who was a care worker in southeastern Pennsylvania, an immigrant from Africa. I remember walking in here with him. He used to wear nice, like, I don't know how he got these leather skin boots, but he had them. Here advocating for a $15 minimum wage. Last June, he died from complications from COVID. I'm thinking of my sister Dana in Pittsburgh, who was a public worker in Pittsburgh, worked for the county, who died months ago from complications of COVID. I'm thinking of the caseworkers like me in Philadelphia, who worked in Glendale District, maybe 4 weeks ago, a gunman came in saying, "Where are the staff? I want to kill a public worker today." And a young security guard named Nasir Day got in front and sacrificed his life, sadly, to protect the 100-odd workers in that building who have no legal protections at their job, almost none, outside of their union contract that the people in that room today are trying to get rid of. So a lot of us are fairly offended that people are literally dying because of the lack of labor laws today. And what's on the docket of that agenda is to talk about to make it easier to get rid of their union, to make it harder for them to bargain the contract, the only thing that provides them a shred of protection. We're not in that hearing today because the hearing's a joke. It's a farce.